Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today, in video 14, we are going to discuss about chemical properties of aldehyde in ketone, in which mainly we will be discussing about reduction to alcohol. Now, what does it mean? Okay. Now, what does it mean? What we say here, that is, either you can reduce it. These three reactions we are going to discuss. Clear? Either you can reduce it with H2 in presence of a catalyst. Clear? Catalyst, either you can use a palladium or platinum or nickel. Can be used as a catalyst, or lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. Clear? This is called lithium aluminium hydride or sodium borohydride. Clear? So this one used for reduction of alcohol. Now when we say reduction means what? Now when we write the carbonyl group, when you use any three of this, mild reduction if you do, it will, that is double bond group. What we say, it will change into C dash here OH and here H, like this it will be. Means, what is the meaning of that? Here double bond O it is what is given. So either what we say means it will be reduced to alcohol. Now why it is called reduced, what we say? The reason is there is an addition of hydrogen in this case. And we know addition of hydrogen is what? Reduction. Okay? So in your book it is not given, only they have mentioned these three things. So the reaction based on this reduction you can write it one by one in your fair book what we say. Okay? So now the first one what is given here, the first one, I will write here reduction. First example. Now the first example when we write, suppose two molecules of we can write it down, 2HCH oil name. When you take two molecules of an aldehyde, actually this is formaldehyde. What is this? Formaldehyde. When you take two molecules of formaldehyde in presence of the catalyst, either nickel or palladium or platinum. Clear? So catalytic hydrogenation, what we call this thing, that is this formaldehyde will change into an alcohol, that is 2CH3OH, that is methanol. It will change into what? Methanol. Actually this was methanol. So methanol is changed to what? Methanol, by catalytic hydrogenation. Okay? Now the second here is written lithium aluminium hydride. So same thing for lithium aluminium hydride. If I take this general form, I write RC, otherwise we will write like this, CH3CHO, what we say, in presence, this I will take it as acetic aldehyde. Clear? Acetic aldehyde in presence of lithium aluminium hydride. LiAlH4, reducing agent what we say, lithium aluminium hydride, what you will get, here CH3, CH2 and OH will get, because two carbons are there and this will get added here. If you don't understand, I can write like this, Ca3C, double bond O and H, okay. So the same thing can be written as CH3C, H, here H and here OH. So this is the same thing, CH2, CH3. So this is your ethanol. What is this? Ethanol. And this is your ethanol. Clear? So aldehyde is changed, ethanol. Aldehyde is changed into ethanol, what we say. Okay? Now the third one. Okay? Now the third reaction, what I am going to talk about, is from what you call it as sodium borohydride. So if you want to write for sodium borohydride, you can write like this. Okay. Now for sodium borohydride, if I take like this, CH3CHO, that is what? Ethanol. Clear? In presence of sodium NaBH4, it will change into CH3CH2OH, that is what? Ethanol. What it will change into? Ethanol. And this will change into ethanol. methanol.
Understood this part? So this is all about what is a sodium borohydride. Okay. So all we have discussed reduction to alcohol. Now in reduction to alcohol means what? Aldehyde can be reduced to alcohol. Clear? But there is one another reaction is also there. That is aldehyde can be reduced to hydrocarbon also. Aldehyde can be reduced to hydrocarbon. In that we are going to discuss about two types. What we say? One is Clemmingson reduction and another is Wolff-Kishner reduction. That we are going to discuss next in this. Okay? So this all three I think you understood. Catalytic hydrogenation, any one of these catalysts, metallic catalysts you can use here, and this lithium aluminum hydride or sodium borohydride, aldehyde can be changed into alcohol. Okay? Now the next part. The next one what we are going to discuss is about reduction to hydrocarbon. So in that two types you are going to see. One is Clemmingson reduction in which zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl that we are going to use for converting the what we call it as aldehyde to hydrocarbon. Second one is Wolff-Kishner reduction. What we are going to use? Wolff-Kishner reduction. In which we are going to use hydrazine. What we are going to use? Hydrazine with the KOH. Clear? Now what is this all things that we will discuss one by one? Clear? So first one what we say? Clemmingson reduction we are going to discuss for this. And another one what we are going to discuss is Wolff-Kishner. Okay? Now,
when we talk about Clemmingson reduction, clear? The first one what we say, we are going to discuss about Clemmingson reduction. Clear? So now what is Clemmingson reduction? So it's simple. In Clemmingson reduction, a carbonyl carbon, what we say, a carbonyl carbon that we have to have in aldehyde and ketone, in presence of zinc amalgam, ZnHg means zinc amalgam. Zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, it will change into CH2. Means you can see this oxygen is replaced with hydrogen here. You understand what I am talking? Means what? Hydrogen is added, that's why it is called reduction reaction. Which reaction? Reduction reaction. Okay. So now suppose if I want to write this reaction, I can write like this. That is, instead of this, this is the general form. CH3C double bond O and H. What is this? This is ethanol. What is this? Ethanol. When treated in presence of ZnHg and concentrated HCl, that is zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, it will change into CH3C. Here H was there and here instead of O, what will be there? H2. So actually this you can write or you can also write it as CH3CH3. Means it change into what? Ethane. And ethane is nothing but what you call it as hydrocarbon. Understood or not? So it change into what? Ethane. You can see here CH3CH2 and H means CH3CH3. It change into ethane. So that's why we call it as this one Clemmingson reduction. What are the reagents used in Clemmingson reaction? So it is zinc amalgam and what you can see here concentrated HCl is being used. Okay? And here the byproduct what is removed is what? H2O in this case. Understood this part? So I think you must have understood this. Okay, now the next one. This was all about Clemmingson reduction. Okay, now we will discuss about Wolff-Kishner. What we will discuss about? Wolff-Kishner. Okay, don't forget this type. This can be asked for 2 marks. Okay, 2 to 3 marks it can be asked. Huh? Remember this one. Now the next one what we are going to discuss is Wolff-Kishner. What is the word? Wolff-Kishner reduction. Clear? Now Wolff-Kishner reduction when we say in this case, what happens in this case? First of all, the aldehyde what we are going to use, that is the carbonyl carbon, is treated with the hydrazine, NH2NH2. This is the nothing but what we call it as hydrazine. The hydrazine. Now, okay, now this we have already discussed. Huh? You will get an addition product if you remember ammonia and its derivative, addition of ammonia and its derivative, what we have seen in the first part. So this hydrazine, if you add, what is removed from here? Water molecule. Okay. So when you get here, you will see C double bond N. From here, what is removed? H2O. From here, what is removed? O. So what it will be? C double bond N. That is amine. What we get? And dash NH2. If you remember, C double bond N dash Z. Nah? Instead of Z, what is there now? NH2. Understood? So this is the addition product what we got. That is hydrazine. Now here, further on reaction with KOH or NaOH, KOH or NaOH in ethylene glycol. In what? Ethylene glycol. Now this you add this what KOH or what we call it as that one in ethylene glycol and you heat this mixture. Okay, you heat this mixture. Either you use potassium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide, you will get what? Now here only we discuss, you will get a hydrocarbon. So when you see here, what it will be? This CH2 will be, and plus this is being removed. What is removed? Nitrogen gas will be removed. So here you can write plus N2. Now this is the gas what is being removed. Understood? So this is the general form what we discuss. I will just read it. When aldehyde or ketone is reacted with the hydrazine, what we say? Followed by the heating with what? Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide in high boiling solvent, that is ethylene glycol. The carbonyl group is reduced to methylene group. The carbonyl group is reduced to which group? Methylene group. You can see there at the last what is written. This is nothing but what we call it as hydrocarbon. What we call it as hydrocarbon. Okay. So it will get reduced to this and then hydrocarbon you get. Its corresponding hydrocarbon is formed. This reaction is called Wolff-Kishner reaction. Now this is the general form. Now this, if you add it like this, I can write like this. See. On example you can take. See. CH3 C double bond O and H I will write. Now in presence, now these two things, now two reactions what we say here, I can write like this. First to react with what? Hydrazine, and then with the KOH, ethylene glycol and heat the mixture. Understood? So when you heat the mixture, this both thing, these two things I have written one by one. So directly instead of this, what you will get? CH3. See, here what we have seen, H2 will be there. Here what it will be? H2, and here H is there. So either you can write or CH3, CH3 you can write, that is ethane you are getting from what? The ethanol. Clear? From ethanol you get ethane. Because in the beginning only we have discussed that the carbonyl group will change into what? CH2. Means it will be replaced. Oxygen will be replaced by hydrogen. That's why it is called reduction. What it is called? Reduction. I think this part is clear to you. Now instead of this, if I am going to use ketone. So here instead of this, I will write here CH3. So this became what? Propanone. Propanone is a ketone. Understood? Ketone. What you will get here? CH3, or we can write here CH2 and CH3, that is propane. What it is? Propane. Okay? So you can see a ketone is changed into what? An hydrocarbon. In the beginning we saw aldehyde was changed into hydrocarbon. So this was all about reduction to hydrocarbon, in which two types of reaction we have seen. First one is Clemmingson. Clemmingson means zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl. Second one what we saw is what? Wolff-Kishner. Wolff-Kishner means what? First you react with what? Hydrazine, in which removal of water will be there. Second time you react with the KOH in a high boiling solvent, that is ethylene glycol, and KOH or NaOH, any of you can use, and heat the mixture, you will get what? Hydrocarbon you get. Okay? So this was all about the two types what we have seen, that is what? Reduction to alcohol and reduction to hydrocarbon. Okay, so now the next topic is the oxidation part. What is the part? Oxidation part. See, when we talk about the chemical properties, they are divided into four parts. First is nucleophilic addition reaction. Then what was there? Reduction. Then what is there? Oxidation, and then reaction due to alpha hydrogen. So these two parts we finish. Which are they? Nucleophilic addition we finish and reduction we finish. Now we are going to talk about oxidation, what we say, okay, in chemical properties of aldehyde and ketone. Next. Okay.
Now the next part what we are going to discuss is about the oxidation. Now in this case, oxidation of aldehyde and ketone, when we say, no, the aldehyde oxidation differs from ketone. What is the reason? Aldehydes can be oxidized by what we call it as mild and strong, both oxidizing agent. While in ketone, we require certain reagents, that is, vigorous conditions are required. Okay, so certain reagents are there, temperature, pressure, that all things that take place when we have to take care whenever you oxidize a ketone. So aldehydes can be oxidized with what? Mild and strong also. Now, what are these mild and strong oxidation? That I will explain, but before that, now suppose when I write like this, R or R, C, double bond O and H. And when oxidation is carried out, oxidation under oxidizing agent, by using which agent? Oxidizing agent. Clear? So when ketone, aldehyde, when you oxidize it by using oxidizing agent, it will change into double bond O dash OH, like this one is it. Okay. Now if you don't understand, we can write like this also. Simple, I will write RC double bond O and H I will write. Okay. So from this only you can easily make out. Here how many oxygen is there? Only one. Here how many oxygens are there? Two. Means it is oxidized. Means aldehyde is oxidized to what? What is this? Carboxylic acid. So this is what? Aldehyde. And that is oxidized to what? Carboxylic acid. Which acid? Carboxylic acid. Because oxygen is added, you can see there. Okay. So therefore, there we use two types of oxidizing agent for aldehyde. One is mild and another is strong oxidizing agent. Okay. Now, when we talk about mild oxidizing agent, which oxidizing agent? Mild oxidizing agent. In your book it is given, tolerance is there, failing solution is there, and Benedict. Clear? So these three are the mild oxidizing agent. When we talk about strong oxidizing agent can be HNO3, that is concentrated nitric acid. Then what we can say, another one is KMnO4. Clear? Another acidic. The one is what? Acidic K2Cr2O7, that is potassium dichromate. So these are strong oxidizing agent. These are mild oxidizing agent. In both of that case, aldehyde will get oxidized to what? Carboxylic. But in ketone, it is not so, because they differ. They require a vigorous condition for oxidation. Okay? So that we are going to discuss. Now first we will discuss about oxidation of aldehyde by mild oxidizing agents. Now before going, what we say, to the oxidation of aldehyde with mild oxidizing agent, in your textbook, this topic is given, that is oxidation of ketone, what we say, under strong oxidizing agent and elevated temperature, means high temperature. Okay. So in that what will happen, the original ketone what we are going to use, no, that will get oxidized into carboxylic acid of mixture of carboxylic acid of less number of carbon. Now what is that? That is explained as a Popoff's rule. Which rule? Popoff's rule. So a question can be asked, state Popoff's rule, give an example. It can be asked for 2 marks. What is the question? State Popoff's rule with example. Clear? So this question can be asked for 2 marks, what we said. But before that, you need to study what is Popoff's rule. So in your textbook, they have given an example like this. What is written? RCH2C double bond O, then CH2R dash. I think like this only it is given. Okay. So in this case, they have written on the top this one as carbon 1, 2 and 3. Understood? So when you use a strong oxidizing agent for ketone, strong oxidizing agent and elevated temperature, high temperature, you can use any of this oxidizing agent, what I say, HNO3 or like this. So in this case, there are 2 types of cleavage will take place. What is the word? 2 type of cleavage. This is cleavage A and this I take it as cleavage B. So what is the meaning of that? If there is a breaking between 1 and 2 carbon, you can see here the number of carbon I have written. So if there is a breakage or cleavage means breaking. So if there is a breaking between one and two carbon, that is this one and two carbon, what will happen? You will get a product. Now what will be the product? So this here, I am talking about this part. So here you will get RCOOH. Why? Because of this two hydrogen, I have written this part. Now one hydrogen is replaced like this. Then the second product when it is, if it breaks from here, that is C1 and C2 cleavage. Clear? So you will get this product what you say. But if it breaks from this part, then what to say from here, then these three carbons will come. Understood what I am talking about? Here, if you didn't understood, this is R and this is R dash. And if here break it. Okay, just a minute. Okay, you can see here. If a breakage is from here, that is C1 and C2 carbon, then these three things we will take in consideration. Means what? It will be R dash CH2 and COOH, like this it will be. Understood? And if the cleavage takes place from this part, that is which part? From here, then these two carbons we need to consider. That is what it will be. If it breaks from here, then these three things we took. And if it breaks from here, understood what I am talking about? If it breaks from here, these three things we have considered. And if there is a cleavage or a breaking from this part, these three things we have to consider. Okay? Clear? So this you will get RCOOH, that is if C1 and C2 carbon cleavage. Okay, this is the product what you get if the from here it breaks. Now suppose. So I will write just for here. Okay, so from here if it is a breakage, that is cleavage A I am talking about A cleavage. Clear? And if you want to see the number, it is C1 and C2 carbon cleavage is there. This is one product and this is the another product what we get. Now suppose if the cleavage is from this side, that is I will write here. You can see the cleavage is of a B type, that is B cleavage. Clear? So if this is the thing, then the product what you will get, the product what you get on oxidation, B cleavage, this was A cleavage. So here you can see if this, then R dash COOH plus this one, that is R CH2 COOH, right? This is C2 and C3 cleavage. Or you can see that C2 and C3 cleavage, or also we can call it as B cleavage. We can call it as B cleavage also. Okay? So this is what we call it as pop-off road. Now why it is called pop-off road? Because it gives a mixture of carboxylic acid with a lesser number of carbon atom than the parent ketone. What does it mean? You can see here. First total, if you count carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon were there. Now in this case, it's giving a mixture of carboxylic acid. Here total carbon only 3. Here total carbon only 2 carbon. Same way here 2 carbon and here 3 carbon. Means less number of mixture of carboxylic acid with less number of carbon atom than the parent ketone. And this rule we call it as a Popoff's rule. This rule it is called Popoff rule. Okay. Now if you want to understand it, this is a general form. Now I will write another form so it will be clear to you to understand this. Clear? Now in that nothing we have to do. We will change this to what here? CH3 and this also CH2CH3 like this. Okay. So R dash I have taken. So now suppose if B cleavage is there, this 3-1 product you get and this 3-1 product you get, what we say. Or I will just change the whole question only, you can see here. You can see the example here. In this case, suppose if I break from here, the bond. So two products you are going to get. Which is that product? This is with 2 carbon and this is with 3 carbon, right? So if A cleavage, that is main product, A cleavage. What I am writing? A cleavage. Cleavage means what? What is the meaning of word? Cleavage means breaking. So if it breaks from here, one product you can see. What is that one product? Because of concentrated HNO3, there is a strong oxidizing agent. What is this? Strong oxidizing agent, what do we say? So what are the product you are going to get? This 3 carbon, that is CH3, CH2, COOH, that is this part I am talking about. Then afterward, this carbon, that is CH3, COOH. Understood? So this is your propanoic acid.
propanoic acid and this is your ethanoic acid. Right? Now suppose if another word, the same thing I'll write and I'll explain like this. CH3CH2CH2C double bond O and CL3. Right? Now suppose if it is a B cleavage. Which cleavage? B. In presence of same what we say concentrated HNO3 and elevated temperature means heating. So what is happening in this case? 4 carbon. So what you will get here? CH3CH2CH2COOH plus HCOOH like this. This one for one carbon you can write HCOOH. So this is your butanoic acid. And this is your methanoic acid. Which acid? Methanoic acid. Understood? So this is the product we got. This is the product we got from main product. Products. From B cleavage. Understood this part? So the same thing you can write like this, what we say. So now what we have to do? We can merge this. How to do this merging? I write this together. You can see CH3 CH2 CH3 CH2 CH2 C double bond O and CH3 like this. Clear? This is A cleavage, this is B cleavage. Okay? And from that, understood? So these are the two things what you are getting. If A cleavage is there, this is the product you get. If B cleavage is there, this is the product you get. Okay? So I think you understood pop-ups more. Understood? Total how many carbons are there on the parent ketone? From that less number of carbon products, carboxylic acid mixture you get in pop-ups rule. Okay, pop-ups rule can be asked for 2 marks. Now after this we are going to discuss now oxidation of aldehyde by mild oxidizing agent. Which agent? Mild oxidizing agent. Okay, that we are going to discuss. Okay, in the next video, not in this, because this video now it already become a lengthier one. So in the next video, we will be discussing about oxidation of aldehyde by mild oxidizing and strong oxidizing agent, both we will discuss. Okay? So till then, thank you very much. What all things we discuss here, what all things we have explained, some notes are written like this, some things are written like this, all things you write down in your fair book. So it will be very helpful for you to understand the topic and read textbook word by word. Okay, so when if any queries are there, you can ask. Otherwise, it will be a problem what we say. Okay, so read it thoroughly. Thank you very much.